Want to know one of my favorite tools for improving the conversion rate of my copy? Stick around because in this tutorial, I'm going to go and edit an email in real time so you can see exactly how I use this free tool to improve flow, readability, and conversions. Keep watching. Hey Posse, what's up? It's Alex coming at you this week with a super simple tutorial that can make a massive impact on your copywriting. If you're new to the crew, welcome. My channel has over 100 in-depth tutorials, copy critiques, and step-by-step guides. So if you want to see more practical and useful tips on improving your copywriting, social media, and marketing skills, then make sure to subscribe below and don't forget to hit that bell to be notified when my next video goes live. Now, real quick pop quiz, the average person reads at what grade level? Is it grade 5? Grade 7, grade 10, or grade 12? If you guessed grade 7, yes, you got it right, which means you should be writing at the 7th grade level to make sure you're speaking to the right audience. That is, unless your customer avatar is in fact college professors. Now, if you're thinking, what? No way, Alex, I'm a real writer. I'm not gonna dumb myself down for a bunch of 7th graders. Well, what if I told you that some of the world's most beloved, well-known, and best-selling authors typically write at a grade 7 level or even below that? Yep, I'm talking about Ernest Hemingway, Jane Austen, J.R.R. Tolkien, and even Stephen King. Just take a look at this reading level analysis where Shane Snow ran a bunch of best-selling fiction books through the Fleisch-Kincaid Index, which is designed to indicate how difficult a passage in English is to understand. Notice how none of these authors wrote above a 9th grade level. And if that's not enough to convince you that your writing can be both captivating and simple, then I'm not sure what will. But one of my absolute favorite and free tools to check the readability of my writing is Hemingway Editor. Yes, this tool was named after the master of literary brevity himself, who, remember, wrote at a 4th grade level. It's a super simple tool that aims to tighten up your words and make them more concise, impactful, and yes, more easy to understand by everyone. So, how does this tool actually improve your conversion rates, you might be wondering? Well, for starters, you want to make sure that the average reader can comprehend your writing. If they can't understand it, then they sure as hell aren't gonna buy it. So, you want your copy and content to be clear and concise, yet bold and relatable. And this tool uses different color codes to highlight lengthy, complex, and difficult sentences so that you know what needs to be sliced and diced, simplified, and optimized. It'll also tell you if your vocab is getting a little too academic or wordy. So to use the Hemingway Editor, just go to HemingwayApp.com and you'll come to the free web version of Hemingway Editor. So all you gotta do is copy and paste your text in and the Hemingway Editor will immediately tell you the readability of your piece. And there are 5 things that the Hemingway Editor will highlight in your copy. All right, so red sentences, that is anything that the Hemingway Editor deems to be too complex. Then there's yellow sentences, and those are hard to read, but not entirely complex. They are still something worth looking into to see if there's any way you might be able to easily simplify those sentences. Blue words are adverbs, which are overly descriptive and don't add that much to your copy. And these are words that you can consider replacing or omitting altogether. And then you have the green words, which is passive copy that could probably be written in a little bit more of a stronger, more direct tone. And lastly, the purple words, which are words that you can replace with a simpler version. So are you ready to see exactly how this works? All right, let's do it. Now, this email is a real email that I sent out during my recent Launchpad promotion. When I copy and pasted it into Hemingway Editor as it was on the day it was sent, it actually scored a 6, which is pretty great. But for the purposes of this video, and because I really wanted you to see a bad example, I went through and I made the copy significantly worse. So now you can see it's ranking at around an 8th grade level, and clearly it needs some work with all that red and yellow in there. So let's get started editing this bad boy. All right, so immediately the first thing you see is that there is a adverb here, which is probably not needed. So I'm gonna go ahead and just omit that all together. This is the moment you've been waiting for. All right, and then this next paragraph, if you are ready to ignite your copywriting business in 2022, keep your eyes glued to your inbox this weekend because enrollment for season 3 of the Copy Posse Launchpad opens this Sunday, January 9th. So one of the easiest ways to tell if a sentence is too complex is to read it out loud with like gusto and see if you can actually finish the sentence in one breath. If you cannot, or if you struggle to do so, it's probably too long. And one of the things that you can do to really simplify your copy is not necessarily to change the words, but to break up those longer paragraphs into shorter, easy to digest sentences. So in this case, if you're ready to ignite your copywriting business in 2022, keep your eyes glued to your inbox this weekend. You know, you could easily go dot, 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 right? Because, capitalize, enrollment for season 3 of the Copy Posse Launchpad opens this Sunday, January 9th. Already, red text is gone. Next, I'll admit. Now, I love those really short coherence markers that can take one paragraph of text and break it into smaller, short little sentences. I would put that on its own line because it really keeps people reading, right? I'll admit, when this program was launched for the first time 2 years ago, so that's passive voice, right? When the program was launched versus when I launched this program. So I'm gonna change this to more active voice. When I launched, if I could spell, this program, remove the passive voice, and already we've completely limited the amount of green there, so that's great. When I launched this program for the first time 2 years ago, right before a global freaking pandemic, I had no idea what I was in for. I think that sentence is fine. It is a little long, but I think that's okay. What I thought I'd be doing was guiding my students through everything I did to ignite my copywriting business from scratch. Again, I think it's okay, right? The goal isn't necessarily to remove every little thing that Hemingway editor deems to be complex or wordy. If it sounds good to you and doesn't read as being too long or verbose, you can absolutely keep it in. Sharing the frighteningly, I'm gonna remove that. Sharing the effective step-by-step trainings on the high level techniques and strategies that I've learned. Okay, this is a doozy. Sharing the effective step-by-step trainings on the high level techniques and strategies that I've learned and tested over the past 10 years, revealing the formulas, tools, and guides that have helped me, right? I can't even finish that in one breath. So let's change this. It says, what I thought I'd be doing was guiding my students through everything I did to ignite my copywriting business from scratch. Sharing the effective step-by-step, let's just say step-by-step techniques and strategies that I've learned and tested over the last 10 years, dot, dot, dot. I love a good dot, dot, dot. Perfect. Revealing the formulas, tools, and guides that have helped me write high converting copy for my million-dollar clients, dot, 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 right? Anytime you're listing something and everything on the list is sort of a mouthful, put it on its own line, right? These could almost be bullet points as well if you wanted to really structure the email to be easy to read. And teaching you how to write an impressive portfolio to show off your highly sought after copywriting skills. Let's get rid of that completely. And teaching you how to write an impressive portfolio to show off, you know what? Your copywriting skills, right? Sometimes it's fun to use adjectives, but if it takes away or makes you stumble over reading it, it's too complex. Take it out. Leave the essence of what we're trying to say here, which is teaching you how to write a portfolio to show off your skills, right? But what happened was even better than I could have imagined. You can already see the grade level is down to a 6. That's great, right? Already just by breaking up those sentences and not really changing overall the essence of the messaging, okay? So because on top of all that, I found my freaking people, a badass posse of heart-centered writers from all backgrounds, countries, and levels of experience who want to use their words to make a difference in their lives, a difference in their families' lives, a difference in their clients' lives, a difference in the world. I think that's okay. The cherry on top, I would make that as a little coherence marker. It's a great open loop. What was the cherry on top? Well, keep reading, right? Was seeing so many of my launch patterns one by one. Again, right? Let's remove some of the language that's a bit wordy. Every time I do that, it goes back up. One by one, launch their copywriting careers, quit their day jobs. Right? These were added in to show you guys. I usually would never use this many adverbs. Omit. Quit their day jobs, explode their income, and create a life of complete freedom on their terms. It's long. How can we shorten this? Maybe say, was seeing so many of my launch patterns one by one, launch their copywriting careers, ... quit their day jobs, explode their income, and create a life of complete freedom on their terms, despite all the challenges of 2020 and 2021. Now it will happen again. The posse and I are back to continue our mission of rallying the raddest and baddest, is just how I say it, I'm not gonna change it, crew of copywriters around the world, and teaching the highly paid copywriting skills, again, passive voice, right, that are needed. No, we wanna say copywriting skills you need to write an irresistible portfolio and ignite your, it's still a bit long, and teaching you the highly paid copywriting skills you need to write an irresistible portfolio. So we kind of already said that. So maybe I would just say, raddest, baddest crew of copywriters around the world and teaching you how to ignite your copywriting business in 2022, right? I took that out because we already said it up here. You know, up here it was revealing all of this portfolio skills. You know, we already said it. We don't need to say it again. Whether you're already a copywriter or brand spanking new, the Launchpad is for you. You can see I have Grammarly installed as well. So I highly recommend you, you know, double team it. Use Grammarly and Hemingway Editor to really edit and finalize your copy. Doors to season 3 will open on Sunday, January 9th, and you better believe it'll be better, badder, and radder than ever before. So you could go like this, right? Notice how so much of what I'm doing is literally just breaking up the lines of text. So keep your eyes on your inbox because we'll be ready for liftoff in 3 days. Let's do this again. P.S. I've added even more additional, right? It's complex, it's redundant. Even more additional. That's something that I notice is really easy to do as writers. We tend to say multiple words that mean the same thing. Even more additional, you can use one or the other, right? So let's just completely remove that. Tools and pieces of training. Pieces of training, you know what? Again, tools and training to this season, including 6 Launchpad exclusive bonuses available to no one else. Wait until you see what I have planned for you. Stay tuned. So already, we took this email from grade 8 to grade 4. Right? So much better, easier to read, and Hemingway has given it its stamp of approval. All right, there we have it. Now, I know that was at the grade 4 level, which is 3 grades lower than the average, but that is okay. Trust me, if you can write powerful copy at an even lower grade level than a grade 7, you are 100% on the right track. So aim for a 7th grade level and lower. Remember, if someone is reading your copy and they reach a point where there's no longer that cognitive fluency, they will leave. Our human brains like simple information that is easy to process. So work through your copy to make it simpler for the average person to read. And this will create a much more effective piece of copy that relates and flows and, most importantly, converts. So give me a thumbs up below if you enjoyed this tutorial and want to see more like it. And until next time, I'm Alex. Ciao for now. All right, guys, if you enjoyed that video, make sure to check out the next one from me right here. And you can click right here to get a free gift. How do I run my business while on the go and traveling the world? While I don't go very far without my laptop in tow, you might be surprised to learn just how much of my business I'm able to run from nothing but my smartphone. So today I'm counting down the top 10 business apps I can't live without.